this was a story of a man who recently converted to Jesus. And how an unbelieving friend sought to see him. Why? So you have been converted to Christ? He said, yes. Then you must be knowing Jesus a lot. Do you know where Jesus was born? The converted man said, I don't know. He further asked the minute details about Jesus, about his parents, about who the baptized, who baptized him, and about his teaching. For all the questions, the man said, I don't know. That answer seems to be the answer comes from the cured blind man. But then he continued telling his friend, 3 years before, I had been a drunkard. My family was falling in pieces. I was in debt. They dreaded the sight of me. But now I have given up drinking. We are out of debt. Ours is a happy home. My children expect my arrival in the evening at home, waiting for me. All this crisis than for us. This much I know Christ, was his answer. Does it not sound like the answer from the blind man who was cured by Jesus? Yes, my dear friends. It is not that the knowledge that we have about Jesus, the scriptural knowledge, the theological inputs that we have, it is not that. But the personal experience with Jesus decides whether we are really his disciple or not. And today we have 3 challenges. The first one is Jesus takes initiative to reach out to that blind man, which tells us that God's grace is, God's presence is in our life. But it is the question whether we are able to receive it or not. And the blind man was open to God's presence in his life when he realized and he was able to experience that presence of God in his life. Secondly, we could see 3 kind of personalities. One is the blind man who knows nearly nothing in the sense, no education, no profound experience in life. But on the other hand, we could see Pharisees who were well versed in scripture and law and all those experience maybe probably put them on a high reputation. But what is the difference between them? The blind man could be able to see the presence of God in his life, whereas the Pharisees couldn't see the Lord's presence in their life. And we are today challenged to look into our life, whether we are able to see and feel and experience the presence of the Lord in our life. And the third thing is, Jesus, the blind man, was bold enough to tell people that he had an experience with Jesus. not because of his resourcefulness, not because of anything else, but rather only because he had a personal experience with Jesus. Maybe in our life we are so much convinced, we are so much there enough because of our experience rather than resourcefulness, or rather than our knowledge, or rather than our all the equipments that we have. No, it's a personal experience with Jesus who decide everything in our life. So we pray together in the in this awful situation throughout the world because of the coronavirus. We ask God's grace so to counter the situation and lit a light that is Christ, that is a belief in Christ. Let this occasion show the faith in all the people in God and in the presence in their life, the God's presence in their life, so much so the darkness prevailing, so much so the unbelief is around because of the coronavirus. We still click on to our faith intact in our life so as to bear witness.